Good morning, viewers. It's a new day. Welcome to today's devotion with the Daily Fountain, the devotional guide of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Invite your family and friends, get your Bible and your Daily Fountain manual while our devotional leader takes us on today's devotion.
Good morning, dear viewers. You are welcome to the Daily Devotional of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion on this 8th day of April 2024. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your grace and your mercy that has brought us to the beginning of another day. As we go into your word, we ask, O Lord, that you will grant us insight of your word. Let there be revelation knowledge. Let your name be glorified in our lives. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Dear viewers, as we look at the Word of God today, the topic before us is Jesus, the way to the Father. And our text is taken from the first epistle of John, chapter 1. We read verse 1 to 4. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled concerning the word of life. The life was manifested, and we have seen and bear witness and declare to you that eternal life which was with the Father and was manifested to us. That which we have seen and heard, we declare to you, that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly, our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ. And these things we write to you, that your joy may be full. The topic we have this morning is very instructive. Jesus, the way to the Father. That topic carries a definite article, the, which is the only definite article in the English language. Jesus, the way to the Father. Not Jesus, a way to the Father. Nor is it Jesus, one of the ways to the Father. The purpose of Apostle John's letter is to bring souls into a relationship with God. In verses 1 and 2, it reads, that which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled concerning the word of life. The life was manifested, and we have seen and bear witness, and declare to you that eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested to us. Apostle Paul began with the beginning. The beginning that Apostle Paul speaks about is eternity and before time, just as it is stated in John's Gospel, chapter 1, from verse 1 to 3, reads, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him, nothing was made that was made. The same eternal word was made manifest, physically real, through incarnation, which he, John, as an eyewitness, declares. This means that the eternal being, the one from the beginning, came to earth, and John, among some other people, personally experienced this eternal one. It is my prayer this morning for everyone hearing the sound of my voice that you will have a personal experience of that eternal one in your life and in your home, in the name of Jesus Christ. It is emphatic that we cannot have the eternal life of the Father without accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. In John chapter 5 and verse 24, Jesus says, "Verily, verily, I say to you, he that hears my word and believes on him that sent me has everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life." Another translation of the Bible, of that John chapter 5, verse 24, a translation, the Passion Translation, says, "I speak to you an eternal truth. If you embrace my message and believe in the one who sent me, you will never face condemnation. In me, you have already passed from the realm of death unto eternal life." You should remember that John chapter 3, verse 16 to 18 says, "God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believes on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." Dear listeners, can you say assuredly that you have this eternal life? Have you really accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? One of the hymns in our Church of Nigeria hymnal, 416, he says, "Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in his grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?" The chorus says, "Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?" We urge our listeners that today we lay aside everything that will make God to look upon us and to say, "Are you really washed in that blood of the Lamb?" Why don't you take an opportunity today and receive that Jesus into your life? And he will surely be your Lord and your Savior. From today's text, John's testimony about Jesus draws us into a sublime fellowship with both God's people and God himself. It is the ancient Greek word koinonia, which speaks of a sharing, a communion, a common bond, and common life. It speaks of a living, breathing, sharing, loving relationship with another person. We all who are in Christ Jesus have this divine life in us. Fellowship with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. This simple and bold statement means that one can have a relationship with God. The word fellowship has in it not only an idea of relationship, but also of sharing a common life. When we have fellowship with Jesus, we will become like him. That is the desire of God, that we will be like him. John chapter 1 verse 12, John's Gospel chapter 1 verse 12 says, "But as many as received him, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name." I pray for everyone hearing my voice this morning. The power to become shall be yours in the mighty name of Jesus. As many as received him, God gives the power to become the sons of God, even to everyone that believe in his name. The result of this fellowship with the Father and his Son, Jesus Christ, is fullness of joy. This joy means an abiding sense of hopefulness and cheerfulness based on God. And this is different from the happiness, which is a sense of optimism and cheerfulness based on circumstances. A child of God is full of joy, everlasting joy. This is independent of the situations and circumstances that surround him. May I ask you this morning, do you have this joy? Do you desire to have this joy? The joy that overcomes challenges of life. Whatever be the situation you are in, there is a joy that calms every storm of life. That is the kind of joy that comes to one who receives him, Jesus Christ, who takes him as his Lord and his Savior. That is the result. Joy everlasting. And today, John the Apostle is telling us he had experienced that joy. And he's saying and calling everyone to also receive that joy. Dear listeners, whatever situation or circumstance that you may be in at this moment, I want to assure you that the Lord is with you. His presence is right there where you are. And what he is saying, he's calling you. He says, "Come to me, all that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." His desire is to give you rest. And he is calling this morning that you should come. Why don't you take advantage of this? Fellowship with Jesus leads to a life lived in fullness of joy. It is not a life that is dependent on situations and circumstances of the country. It is not a life that is dependent on circumstances of life. It is a life that is joyous, that is radiant, irrespective of the situations and circumstances of life. And that is the life that you are called on this morning. Fellowship with the Father. That is the intention of the writer of this first epistle of John. And that exactly is what is being conveyed this morning, that we will come into a fellowship with the Father. That is the desire of God. He desires to fellowship with us. And Jesus is the one that has come to pave that way. He is the way to the Father. If you desire that fellowship, why don't you give your life to Him? Why don't you receive Him as your Lord and your Savior? Why don't you commit the entirety of your life to Him? Why don't you say, Jesus, come into my life. Make me a new person. The Bible says, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. One of the new things is that you come in fellowship with the Father. A warm union. You relate with your Heavenly Father on a daily basis, moment by moment basis. You speak to Him. He responds to you. You listen. The Holy Spirit speaks. It inspires you. It encourages you. It tells you that you are not alone. You will not walk this road alone. I will always be with you. He encourages you every morning, telling you that I will be with you wheresoever you go. And this morning, the word is coming to you, saying that the Father desires fellowship with you. And Jesus is the way to the Father. Jesus is the one that is the bridge between God and man. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through Him. Jesus is the one that calls us into a true fellowship with the Father. Jesus leads us to a life of joy in the presence of the Lord. And that is the desire for everyone that is listening to me, that you also will be a partaker of that heavenly joy, a joy that transcends the situations of this nation, the circumstances that surround us, all the uphills that we experience. Jesus is calling us, pointing us to the Father, and He's saying, come. This morning, do you desire that? Do you want Him to be indeed your Lord and your Savior? Today, you receive Him and you come into fellowship with the Father. This is a prayer that I pray with you this morning. That Lord will give you understanding of this word, and you will also come into fellowship with the Father. Let us pray. Lord, may I never lose or miss the eternal fellowship with you above. And I pray for all my listeners this morning that fellowship that Jesus has come to enact between God and man, we will not lose sight of it. We will also come into full fellowship with the Father, and our lives will not be the same again. Amen. Thank you very much, listeners. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. Amen.
We thank you for fellowshipping with us today. We invite you to join us tomorrow morning, same time, same station, for another special edition of the Daily Fountain. If you are led to sponsor or support this program, please contact the numbers and email all showing on your screen. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/ACNNTV. Visit our website www.acnntv.com.